Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how to calculate cash receipts using the sales budget. Now, we've been looking at the master budget, and within the master budget, your very first budget is that sales budget. But we know that sales is not the same as cash collections, right? We give our clients terms such as 210 net 30 or 315 net 45 that give them an extended period of time to pay. And so because of that, our cash collections may not occur in the same quarter as the actual sales. So here we have some collections information, and we can use that information to create a schedule of expected collections. Now, our first step is to take our sales from our sales budget and plug those into our schedule of expected collections. Now, we can look at our collections information. It tells us 75% are collected in the quarter sold and 25% are collected in the following quarter. So what that means is for our quarter one sales, if we have 42,000 in sales, 75% of those, or 31,500, would be collected in quarter one, and the other 25% of those would be collected in quarter two. It would be the same way for quarter two. If we have 54,000 in sales, now, we're not going to collect any of those in quarter one because they haven't happened yet, right? These are quarter two sales. But we would collect 75% of them in quarter two and the other 25% in quarter three. Next, we can move to the third quarter. If we have 48,000 in sales, again, none of those would be collected in quarter one or quarter two, but 75% would be collected in quarter three and 25% of those in quarter four. And lastly, if we look at quarter four sales, we wouldn't expect to collect any in quarters one, two, or three because it hasn't happened yet. And 75% of those would be collected in quarter four. Now that other 25% would actually be collected in the quarter one of the next year, which really would be accounts receivable, right? And so that would be on your budgeted balance sheet as accounts receivable. But we're not really worried about that for right now. However, our information tells us that there was some accounts receivable last year. At December 31 of the prior year, there was 15,000 accounts receivable, and they expect to collect that in the first quarter of our current year. So we are going to add that one into our schedule. Now we can take our columns and add them up, and this gives us our total collections. So again, these are the amounts that would be shown for each quarter in our cash budget as our expected cash collections. Now let's look at another example. Here we have some budgeted sales and our information is a little bit different. The first thing we'll see here is that it tells us sales are 40% cash and 60% credit. Now obviously cash sales would be collected at the time of sales, right? That's when a customer comes in, buys their products, and pays you right now. So the first thing we need to do is take that sales information and separate it into our cash and credit sales, which were 40% for cash and 60% for credit. Now we can move into creating our schedule of cash collections. So again, first we're going to list our cash sales. Those would be expected to be collected in the month of the sale. Now we can look at our credit sales. Now it tells us on our information that credit sales are collected 20% in the month of sale. So that means that for each of our months, we can expect to collect 20% of that credit sale amount. So we can take each of our credit sales, multiply them by 20%, and add them into our schedule. Next, our data tells us that credit sales are collected 65% in the month following the sale. Now that would mean that December credit sales, 65% of those are collected in January. And our January credit sales, 65% are collected in February. So everything's kind of shifted over a month. Okay, now we don't know what December sales were, but that's fine because we're only trying to really calculate the March collections here, right? But we know that in February, they're going to collect 65% of the sales that happened in January. And in March, they're going to collect 65% of the credit sales that happened in February. So we can add those into our table. Next, we see that cash collection or credit collections are collected 10% in the second month following the sales. So again, that means that if a sale takes place in January, 10% of those credit sales are collected 2 months later in March. Okay, now we don't really know the January and February information because again, we don't have those December and November sales information, but we don't really need it because ultimately we're just trying to calculate March. Okay, and we know again that in March, they're going to collect 10% of the sales that occurred 2 months ago, right, in January. So we can add that into our schedule. Okay, so then we can take it, we can add up our total credit collections. And then taking our credit plus our cash collections, we can determine here that we would expect to collect $185,088 in March. Okay, now another way we can kind of look at this again is in March, we're going to collect the cash sales from the March transactions. Okay, we're also going to collect 20% of our credit sales that occurred during that month. We will also collect 65% of the ones that happened in February. And for our sales that happened 2 months prior, we'll be collecting 10% of those. So we can see here that each month is included here in our March calculation. So again, the total expected March cash collections would be $185,088. Okay, I hope that helps you to understand how to calculate the cash collections based on sales information, and good luck on your problems.